Good afternoon and welcome back to Christianity 101. I am your professor, Pastor John. This is a series that we're doing at Light on the Hill where we're just kind of going back through some of the basic things of being a Christian and just kind of talking about them a little bit in depth, really hitting back on the basics. So it should be good for anybody who is a new Christian who's just found faith this past year, or somebody who has been a Christian for a while and just kind of wants to get back to the basics within their own lives. So our topic for today is how to pray. And we find actually a very good template within Scripture, which is the Lord's Prayer. And that is what the purpose of this, of that section is. We're not literally supposed to play the Lord's Prayer every time we pray. I mean, you can, but it's really meant to be like, this is how you should go about structuring your prayer. Now, I want to emphasize that Jesus is, I don't believe, is also suggesting that this is the only structure that you can ever make your prayers as. I think he's okay with us being even simpler than this, but he was really trying to kind of clear out some of the blocks for his own disciples and give them a way to pray that wouldn't make things too complicated for themselves, or, you know, get them hung up on exactly how they should try and go about approaching God. So what is that structure? Well, he starts out by having us praise God and pray for the coming of his kingdom. So you're starting out really focusing on God. You're giving him praise. You're thanking him for all the stuff that he's done in your life, those types of things. And you're also praying that he will bring his kingdom to this earth, which is something that as all Christians, we should have a deep desire to see happen. Now, after that, you then can move into talking about your daily bread, specifically what you need in your life today. We all have those prayer requests and those things that we are facing in our own lives that we want to see taken care of. And this is, you know, we should bring those to God, and we should go to God consistently on those. Now, I want to put a little bit of a caution here, and it's something that is important to understand. The purpose of prayer, and especially praying for things to come about in our lives, is not to get those things necessarily. It's really more about finding our way into being unified and one with God's will for the entirety of creation in our own lives. And that's a very important thing to emphasize here. Jesus, later on in the Gospels, he prays in a very similar structure in the Garden of Gethsemane. And, you know, his daily bread at that point, his thing that he was praying for, is for God to take the cup for him. That was specifically referring to dying on the cross. Now, God said no to him. And Jesus is God's own son. So if God says no to Jesus, who's his own son and is, you know, divine, then that probably means that we're not always going to get what we want that we pray for. So we need to keep that in mind. And the idea here is that we should be seeking, we should still go to God with what we want, but we need to be open to the possibility that God's plan is something completely different than what we really want. And we need to find our strength from praying for these things, as well as our peace with aligning with God's will in that sort of way. So after that, praying for forgiveness for ourselves and others, this is very important. We should spend some time, praying for forgiveness for our own sins, for our own mistakes, but also praying to God and letting him know that we're going to let this person, that let these things that happen to us, maybe somebody cut you off on the road and you're really mad at them, giving that up to God and letting it go and forgiving that individual, that's an important thing for us to do. For our own mental health, as well as just, as a way to show God that we're not just thinking of ourselves here, that we're willing to be forgiving ourselves, and hopefully he will give us the same sort of grace. That's partially why, you know, it says, forgive us our trespasses as we forgive others. And finally, building off of that last point, just to help helping us avoiding temptation. If we go to God and we ask him to help us avoid sin and to lead us out from that, God will respond to that, and he will give us the strength and the willpower to resist those types of temptation. So we should always try and incorporate that into our prayer. Now, as I said, this is a set of guidelines. You don't have to follow this exactly, but it is a good place to start, especially if you don't know what you necessarily want to pray. And I do think that all us as Christians, we should sometimes try and make a conscious effort to really structure our prayers this way, because it's a good spiritual practice. So with all that being said, I wish you all well. Go forth, let your prayer lives be rich and blessed, and may you find yourselves in line with God's will. Amen.